All right, it's starting out pretty good. All right, good start. All right, pretty nice sound, by the way. Okay, we started out pretty good. Yeah, this is a nice one. Okay, let's hear it. Pretty nice lyrics, huh? I really do like these lyrics. Don't worry, my love for magic lyrics has usually has been decent to pretty good. But this one is these are pretty good lyrics to listen to. It actually does feel like, almost feel like a song. And it's actually like a, what song, this is the type of song, does look like a type of song he was singing. Since his song actually matched the style of what he's singing about. There's a few singers that don't do that as much as him. But that's not shame. Like, well, some singers that don't do that as much as him. You know, they don't really sing songs that they match what they're singing about. You know, a few people from the 80s, and of course, there's many from right now. But he almost always does this. You know, he matches songs that matches his rhythm of what he's singing about. Like this one. Reason why, because one, his music, for some reason, is always upbeat and always interesting to listen to. Two, of course, his songs are always about something that's important to do for our lives, like digging up gold. He sings a song called Gold. But why are you saying this, you might ask? Well, it's because I think his songs are pretty good. And to me, they don't constantly repeat the exact same word of the type of the song so much it gets irritating. No, he sings it enough times where you can honestly tell what he means by the title of the song. Like, many of his songs, of course, just gonna be pretty obvious what he's singing about. I like how he's, of course, sings the title of the song. And of course, I like how he doesn't constantly repeat it, unlike other people who, unfortunately, says it so much, where nowadays it gets annoying, or still gets annoying to this day. He doesn't do that, thankfully. Next is his other song, Radioactive.
Like, you want to score it again? You have to score it.
So, does it feel like a song? Yes. Feeling the, of course, the visuals, to me, of course, get a 23 out of 25. The sound gets to me a 21 out of 25. 23. This. Lyrics get a 17 out of 25. And of course, finally, is it like the song? Almost gets a 10 out of 25. So, 71 out of 100.
Okay.
The song is pretty decent. It's not. And of course, next is the song Radioactive.
Push that.
Okay, then. We'll start out good enough. Let's see. Oh, this has been interesting. That's kind of interesting. They starring Elf, but not really him in the frame of the song yet. That's kind of interesting. Now remember, most of Imagine Dragons songs start with him in the frame of the song. Alright then. Oh, there he is! Ah, they finally put him in there. I actually saw the song before, and it's the first time I've heard an Imagine Dragons song. Oh, they put him in frame. Ah, there you go. This is kind of interesting. Wow, this is pretty cool. Alright then, we have puppets and of course him and Fane singing. And of course, I love this. This is my favorite part. I've never seen this part before, but I really like how they show two puppets fighting. To me, sounds awesome! And of course, they show puppets falling. Hardly any songs do that, you know, show someone falling down. Yeah, hardly any songs do that, showing someone falling hard down. Okay, let's see what you got. I really like these rituals, and this. Okay then, let's see. Oh man. And of course, they finally got to my favorite lyric they sing. Wow. That's kind of cool, actually. Songs nowadays can't show as much as what they do in the past and before. Okay, it ends there. Pretty interesting song, I gotta say. That's kind of cute. Boy, what's happening to him? Oh. Alrighty then. So, does it feel like a song? Kind of. I give the visuals 7 out of 25. My favorite one is when the puppet thing was battling the toy-like things. That was kind of awesome. I like how that teddy bear has lasers coming out of his eyes. The lyrics, I find them pretty good, pretty okay. 12 out of 25. Is it like a Imagine Dragon song? Almost 20 out of 25. And of course, finally, how do I feel about the rest? you know, how I feel about the sound. Well, the sound, it somehow needs some work, but it's fine enough. 8 out of 25. And then, yeah, I'm not interested in as much as the other songs. Next is the song, Thunder. So how do you feel about the score compared to the last one?
Me?
Mm-hmm.
I think... Oh. Did you really... Well, it depends. I think you did a good job with trying to figure out what the song was about.
Yeah. Anyways, his next one is his song, Monster. This is kind of interesting. We're starting out interesting enough. Alright, and let's hear it. Okay. So, this is interesting enough. Alright, pretty good lyrics. Nice one. I like this. Alright then. I like this. Really do. Visuals to show, but still pretty good. Alrighty then. This is actually my favorite Imagine Dragon song. You hear this more and more when I get to the score I get to. Alrighty then. Like this, really do. Okay, we get to the end. Okay, then. This is an interesting song. Very interesting song. And one of my favorite Imagine Dragons songs. Alright then, I really like this, I really do. Man, is that a pretty good one. Okay. So, does it feel like the song, with no visuals, it almost does not, but, does it feel like the song? I get that, a 6 out of 25. The lyrics I thought were fine, but for some reason I thought some of the lyrics repeat themselves a little bit too much, so I give that a 16 out of 25. Is it like an Imagine Dragons song? Yes, almost definitely. Give that, and of course, a 12 out of 25. And of course, finally, the sound. Kind of interesting sound. Kind of interesting sound. 21 out of 25. Okay, then. It's kind of my favorite song, but I wish some things were a little bit better. Anyways, let's move on to his next song, Thunder.
I'm gonna push that button.
Alright, let's get to it. This is also my favorite song to listen to the Imagine Dragon. So let's see what he has in store. Right. Oh, it started pretty good. Alright then. Pretty interesting. Ah, these are pretty good lyrics. Not kind of interesting lyrics. I think I put this almost first place. Not entirely the very top. Let's see what this song has. They actually use someone else dancing to the song. Where they actually use someone dancing to the song. I kinda like that. Of course the song uses mixed with, of course, lyrics that I'm not used to Gaming's, Imagine Dragons singing, but kind of interesting. Of course. Some of my thought were kind of a little too weird. Nice wheel pulling view. I like that. That's my favorite part of the song. Alrighty then, you can actually see what's going on. Alrighty then, let's do this. Alright, and how I feel about the song. Okay, does it feel like a song? Almost. I get that. But okay, so, does it feel like a song? Yeah, almost. 17 out of 25. The lyrics. Some of the lyrics were a little too weird. I get that 8 out of 25. But some of the lyrics I wasn't expecting to actually sing, like clapping a nosebleed. That's a little offense to anime, but you guys don't know. Well, almost like it. Yeah. Of course, I really... How about the sound? I really enjoy the sound. 21 out of 25. And of course, I really, really do like... I really think it almost is like an Imagine Dragons song. I get that an 18 out of 25. Yeah, it's like, it's one of my favorite songs. But I wish I can kind of see what the lyrics and kind of see what the rest of the song was going for. Anyway, my next one is the final one by Imagine Dragon.